what's up, everyone? It's me, Carnitas. So I know I haven't been posting MK1 content, nor have I been really talking about MK1 in a long time. The last thing I really responded to was, in all honesty, just the DLC review. I've never actually posted any other reactions to the game, and there's nothing wrong with the game per se. Well, I can't lie. There's quite a few things that I don't love about the game. And it's not really the character roster per se, but more of the certain gameplay aspects that I don't like. I'm not a big fan of cameos. I really don't like the direction they went with character costumes. There's just some things that I really just don't like that NRS did for the game. But personally, what will always get me to come back to any fighting game and just keep trying to play it, and maybe I'll relearn to love it again, is when a character comes out. And one of the big characters that I am so looking forward to, and honestly it's one of my favorite characters, like, of all fighting games. It was one of the few characters that when I played the original MK9, for example, it's what kept me playing the game and coming back and having really stupid fun. That character was Ermac. Ermac actually was one of my favorite characters back in UMK3. I've always liked how he looked. He was the red ninja. Everyone always likes, you know, the blue and the yellow ninjas, aka Scorpion and Sub-Zero. And, you know, everyone kind of does. But for me, the red ninja was always the coolest one in my book. So I really liked him. I've been playing him since UMK3. I played him in Deception, Armageddon, even in MK9. MKX, I did not play that much, sadly. But MKX also had another ninja that I love, and that's Tremor. And so in this game, I get both the option to have a Tremor cameo, as well as just having Ermac. So generally, I'm excited for this. Now, of course, upon DLC announcement, they showed Ermac without a mask. And I'm here to announce, they gave him the mask! So I'm really happy to see that. I think that's my biggest thing for it. Let's go ahead and take a look at the trailer, and I'll give you guys my general reaction. Originally I was going to stream this, but I have no time. I have to get ready for work, and yeah, so we're going to go ahead and just watch the trailer. Hope you guys enjoy. I forgot my headphones. No! Bad. And here we go.
You have shamed the souls of your ancestors. Which of my ungrateful kin are within you?
Please, let him be fun. That's my biggest ask. Just let him be fun.
Fight.
I love his. Oh, that walk, though. Okay. Okay. Okay, so he's got flight. Oh, okay, Movado. He's got Teleslam, okay. Whoa, wait.
You might be many, but I am the one.
You are not even Earthrealm's champion.
Okay, interesting. Okay. He's got like an EX form. Okay, kind of sick.
Since we first met,
we believe for the better.
Yo, Reptile with a new move. Two new moves. Okay. He's got some MKX to him, as well as... It's mostly MKX, not really MK9 per se. He's got his teleport from MK3 though. Or not MK3, MK9. He's got flight cancels. Uh-oh. And it's on another Tuesday! It's on Taco Tuesday! Let's go. This design's kind of cooking, I ain't gonna lie. I love his neutral stance. Like, his neutral stance is so, like, intimidating. He looks a lot, like, darker in this form. I like it. Wait, was that his dash? Oh god, this character's dash, hold on. No, it's just his regular walk. So he's got, it's not exactly Master of Soul, but a way of capturing on the ground. So he's like, has a lot of like re-stand like combos. So look at this. Okay. I think they brought back, this is his back two, I believe, from MK3, MK9. MK9, he had a back two. And you can cancel all of it. Because look, he's charging it, and backdashes out of it. So I think he's got that back.
You might be many, but I am the one.
You are not even Earthrealm's champion.
I would really laugh. So right here. That kick. Right there, that might just literally be his standing like three. So he's got some sort of EX form that gives him like enhanced versions of all his special moves. So that's gonna be his big gimmick, is you want the enhanced form as often as possible. He's got a DP, he's got like a AOE. Cool enders. So right here, this is the chat. This is the thing I saw everyone else talking about on Twitter. Not just the fact that Ermac's back, but Reptile got buffed. This guy's pretty sick. Right here, he can do his tail flip and then teleport back. And then he has a fast big projectile. My only fear is I suck with flight cancels. But overall, I mean, really cool. I love. Just one subtle change to Ermac made him look like one of the coolest characters in MK1. Literally, they gave him a mask, instant top tier. Like, instant, like, oh, this is amazing. This is awesome. They didn't need, if he didn't have the mask, I think his design would have been ruined. I think the design is still ruined. Because if you want to see what that looks like, yeah. Big freaking difference. So overall, I'm happy to see, you know, my favorite MK character come back, and for me that's huge because I want to play the game more. Tanya definitely is a fun character. I think she's really fun, but she's also kind of simplistic in, like, she's simple in theory, and the harsh reality is, like, she's only good with like two cameos, like two or three, and then that's it. And that's what kind of bums me out about MK1, is that a lot of the cameos just feel kind of, they're either busted as shit, or you have to use very specific ones with characters. You can't just universally use all of them. They don't all work on the same like wavelength with every character. And kind of, it's rough. I think there's some things that it's like, well, I want to use Sector, but the Sector cameo doesn't work well with Tanya, so you can't do shit with it. Theoretically, at least. I found some stuff, but it's mostly just to keep you safe, and some combo extension, but it's not all that great. So for Ermac, I'm hoping that I can kind of have, you know, a fun cameo either in the form of Sector or Tremor. If I can do Tremor Ermac, I would love that. I think that would be super fun. I would love to play MK1 like that. And I'll definitely try it. So look forward to this Tuesday chat when Ermac returns.